Hey everybody, so I just got my skills bag in, and I remember that I told y'all that as soon as my skills bag in, I would be doing a video. So I'm also gonna like try to show y'all my books in this video and go over my supplies for second semester. So let's get started. So before we get into my skills bag, I just kind of wanted to show y'all some of the books that I'm going to be using this semester. These books right here are either supplemental books or books from last semester, like from here to here. So don't pay attention to those. These are my ATI books. Our school has gives us a huge box of these our first semester, and they come with our program. I'll be using this one. As you can tell, I've already started reading. It's like right now it's like a week before school starts. I think I'll also be using, there's one for foundations. Where's it at? Oh, or fundamentals. There's my fundamentals of nursing and my nutrition. I can just move this over here because this right here from the paper punch over are all the books that I'll be using for this semester. So we have our pharmacology. I'm gonna be honest, I haven't had a chance to open that one yet. And then the student workbook, didn't know I needed that until like last minute, so I just bought this today. Now, I will say I've only bought this one, the pharmacology workbook, and I bought the APA publication manual. I bought those used because I'm going to need those. Like, I really am going to need those. And it's same for physical examination and health assessment and the workbook. I bought these two because I know I'm going to probably reference those again. But like some of these other ones, I've been told from other nurses that they never looked at them again. And the cool thing is even if I did need these again, I have my ATI books to reference to that I already own. So, moving on, I got the Math for Meds. I'm going to be using that this semester. And then Fundamentals of Nursing. And then my Nursing Diagnosis Handbook. So, these three. And Prioritization, Delegation, and Assignment. Those are for my Foundations class, I think. Yeah, those are all just for my foundations. And then, of course, pharmacology is for pharmacology. And then my publication, APA, I'm going to use it for all of them. But yeah, the prioritizing, that's foundations. And then I have my understanding nutrition book. Those are the classes that I'm taking this semester. And then my supplementary ATI books to go along with them. And yeah, basically, that's it for my books. I did not expect that because my last stuff that I got was like very cheaply made. So I am excited because this looks like it's going to be durable. That means I'm not going to have to buy another clinical bag or another skills bag, I don't think. I think this one will do just fine for now. Or I can just use one of my regular small purses. So yeah, I'll keep you updated on what I'm going to need for clinical. But this is my skills bag. This is for me to practice in lab. Like all the different skills I'm going to learn, like IVs, wound care, that kind of thing. So I open up this top pocket. We have another strap, I guess, so that I can carry it on my shoulder. It smells like medical supplies in here. So this is going to be really important that I don't get anything on this, and then I pack this the same way that I take it out. So let me just move a couple of my items off of here that might get in the way. Okay, so we have a personal protection gown. These are those yellow gowns that you see people wear before they go in to a room that has like precautions. We have dextrose injection mini bag plus container. Like, that's pretty cute. Look, it's just like a tiny like IV bag. Says 100 milliliters, contains 5 grams of dextrose hydrous USP. It tells you like the osmolarity and stuff on there. All right, and then we have a sodium chloride IV bag. Yeah, I guess this is like to hydrate somebody. Probably not. I don't know what I'm talking about yet because I haven't taken this class. Oh. We have another little bag of dextrose in these little sandwich bags. Okay, so let me move that over here so I don't get anything else on those. Then, oh gosh, this is packed in here pretty tight. Like, let me see if I can. So, I'm not gonna like, I might take one of these out each, but I'm not going to open it up because it's like sealed. So don't want to like get in trouble for having stuff open. That's not supposed to be open. Let's see. Okay. We've got this. This is a suction catheter kit. It tells you what's inside, so we don't even have to open it. We can kind of see a little bit what's going on, but not really. It says it has a whistle tip suction, catheter, vinyl gloves, sterile wrap, and a cup. So, yeah. Let me move some of that off here. And then, I gotta remember where that went. Oh, we also have another sodium chloride drip. All right, now comes those bigger parts that I was talking about just a second ago. So, this says it's a barred latex-free Foley tray. So basically, this is for Foley catheters. And there are, let's see, there are 1, 2, 3 of those in this bag. We're going to be learning how to do catheters real good, apparently. And then here at the end, we have a tracheostomy clean and care tray. And then in this little package, we have a dressing tray. It tells you there's a wrap, pair of gloves, drape, reclosable bag, povidone iodine, I don't know if I pronounced that right, abdominal pad, rolled bandage, 1 medical tape, 10 gauze sponge, 2 applicators, 1 scissors, and 1 forceps. So that's a wound dressing tray. This is a inner cannula. I don't know about y'all, but I'm a little excited about clinicals and learning really awesome nursing skills this semester. Oh, there's something down in here. Here we have a back check valve. Alaris pump infusion set. That looks like something I've never seen before. Which a lot of this stuff is stuff I've never seen before. So, all right. So, that is it for what's in this main part. Let's see if there's anything in the side pockets. But first, let me put all this stuff back the way I got it out. see if there's anything in these side pockets. Feels like there is. So here we have a BD secondary set. We have two of those. Ooh, this looks fun. Okay, so I don't know what's all in here. Maybe we'll open it up in just a second. This looks like it has a lot of stuff in it. Yeah. Should we open it? Probably. I don't know if I want to take all this stuff out. Because then I have to put it back in there. There's orange wood sticks, I believe, or cotton tip applicators, sodium chloride. I don't know what this is. But real quick, let's see what's on the other side. Different. So we have a urethral catheterization tray. It's a vinyl urethral catheter. And it's all wrapped up and sterile, so we won't open this. And then this is also wrapped up and sterile. And this is a irrigation tray. Nothing in there, but this thing is packed. Like, I'm not going to say that I'm not, like, I knew there was going to be a lot in here because it's pretty decent size and it's, like, packed to the brim. It's not light. It probably weighs about 15 pounds. 15 pounds? Maybe I'm exaggerating. We'll say 10 pounds. Maybe it's the size of, like, a 10-pound bag of sugar as far as weight-wise. So, yeah, I'm going to pause this and we're going to look through that one bag and see what is all in there. All right, better lighting. So, here's that bag that I just showed you. We're going to gently take things out and look at them because I have a feeling that, like, it doesn't say sterile, and all the things that are sterile are supposed to remain sterile. We'll just, like, leave in their little things. So, a sterile flocked collection device. Interesting. It looks kind of like, I don't know, like a weird spoolie brush with like a plastic casing. So we have one of those. We have conforming stretch gauze bandages. Sodium chloride injection. We have a smart site extension. Pretty sure that's like for IVs. But like I said, new student, don't really know. Aww. Here is a mini tint vial. It's so tiny. Here we have several 2 milliliter glass vials. What does that say? It just says training. So I'm not really sure what that's for, but there's like 3 in here. I was really curious about this when I was looking. This says Cardinal Health. I think this is a specimen. Yeah, collector thing. So it says collection, transport, and swab. So it's for collecting samples of whatever, like body fluid. Kind of reminds me of the same stuff you see like on medical shows where they're like, or like, I watch a lot of murder mystery shows and they'll like put that under the fingernails or something. I don't know. All right, and so then this is another sterile thing we're not gonna open. It's an IV start kit. So it looks like there's one of those little rubber band things that they, like a rubber band tourniquet or a rubber tourniquet. And like, there's like a little, there's alcohol prep pad in there. Cool stuff. I think that's the only thing that I hate is that we cannot film during, we can't film during like lab and stuff. So I'll be able to show you all the cool things I get to do. But I don't know. Maybe I can ask my instructor once to see if they'll let me do that. Here's another IV start kit. Here are those long cotton swabs that I was talking about. There's several of these. We have an we have two abdominal pads so far. There's a lot of stuff in this little bag. A Tegaderm film. Pretty sure this is that same stuff that you see them put on someone's arm, and then they have the IV in, and that way you can see that the that the needle is like in the arm, because it's like see-through. I think that's what that is. Says transparent film dressing frame style. Who knows? I could be wrong, but I think that's what that is. Drain sponges. Don't know if that's for yet. Ooh, this is interesting looking. So here we have Practa powder. It's fructose and tartrazine. It's for training. It says it's unsterile, and it's for practice dosages. Sorry, I went to shake it and it went flying. Practice dosages. Interesting. Huh. Oh, here we go. This is probably like saline or something. Yep. Normal saline. So there's two of these. It just says normal saline. For moistening of wound dressings, wound debridement, and device irrigation. So there's two bottles of that. And then, oh, we have little, these are like clamps, I think. It's like a clamp. Pretty sure if that's what that is. And then here are some syringes. It says do not place syringe on a sterile field. Oh, it has sodium chloride in it. So these are, it's a normal saline flush. So that's probably for practicing something as well. All of this is for practicing stuff, not to use on real humans. I should add that. Here's more gauze and bandages. Woven gauze bandage. There's one, two, three of those. Another drain sponge. Here we have a polyline drape for use in the sterile field. Helps prevent strike through. And all of this stuff is from Medline. That's where they got all of our stuff from. Oh my gosh, I seen these in our video where we were talking about precautions. We had to watch these videos before school starts next Monday. And it's like a face shield, but like it's like a mask, but it also like shields your eyeballs, which looks really funny, but you ain't gonna get no blood splatter in your eyeballs, so, or urine, or spit, or whatever, who knows, but yeah, that's what that is. So let's gently put all this stuff back in there. Well, put this in there, but yeah, it's pretty cool for a skills bag. I'm really excited. So quick update. Before I wrap this up, I start school next Monday, and it is what's the word I'm looking for? It's already, you know, they're already putting the pedal to the metal, so to speak, because we have assignments due the first day of class. Like, I've always heard people talk about that kind of thing, but it's actually never happened to me. Like, don't get me wrong, I would read before the first day of school, but that was because I wanted to, not because I had to. And this time it's because I have to. So I've got about like 5 or 6 more chapters to read in the next 2 or 3 days, which isn't terrible, could be worse, but I'm not gonna lie, it's very interesting how things are already starting to get kind of cray cray. But yeah. So, I'm excited for this semester. I'm excited to be doing these videos so that y'all can watch me grow and so that I can kind of look back and see where how far I've came. It's pretty cool stuff. So, oh yeah, I gotta get this all back in there the way I got it out, kind of. We'll just stick all of that in there, just like that. Make sure I'm not leaving anything out. So yeah, that's it for my school's bag, and that's it pretty much for this video. If you like this video and you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe. And if you have any comments about anything, you can comment below. I will be doing a video pretty soon on what I take with me to clinical. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you all for tuning in. And yeah, I'll talk to you later.